Shokugeki no Soma chapter 218. This chapter was pretty much just hype, and it was pretty simple, and it was still a pretty good, enjoyable chapter. And so basically what this is, you have Alice trying to come up with a plan, all the whole gang is together, trying to figure out who is going to be the ones chosen for the next matches. And it's kind of interesting, you kind of wonder who's it going to be, but you kind of know, because we're waiting for guys like Subaru, and Migishima, thank God, is coming in for the next round, because we did not see anything from him at all. And I guess that was the author's move. You know, I didn't like that he just wiped out the fifth seed, and there's like no hype around this guy, but it's kind of kept in secret, so I guess you can look at it that way. So I'm looking forward to this matchup that he has going on, especially with that reveal, the ending of the chapter. And I'll explain my predictions at the end of this review. So you have, also as that is going on, you have Edina, and she's like the team captain. She's really smart. She's really very clever. She's trying to come up with a game plan for them to win. She doesn't want to lose any of the momentum that they have to the Elite 10, because if you lose momentum, momentum is pretty much everything. It's all about, it's like kind of a chess game, but ultimately it comes down to who has the better chefs, you know, who has the better cooking. That's all it comes down to. You can game plan as much as you want. But let's look at the facts. The Elite 10, they have the stronger cooks. They have the stronger fighters, man. They got the first seed and the second seed. And it's going to be really hard to beat them if you look at it like match for match. Because they have to like, they're going to have to outscore them. And if you look at it, the Elite 10 should win, but just barely. And who knows? It all depends on who can become a greater cook than they were yesterday. Who can become a better cook than they were 10 minutes ago. And that's all what it comes down to, is who can improve himself that much quicker. And that's why I think it's going to come down to this matchup, is who is going to be able to adjust the best. And as that's going on, you have Yukihira walking around, and he overhears Kuga. And man, we always see a side of Kuga that he never shows to anyone else whenever he's talking to Suga in the first seed. And he shows like a nervous sign, like he knows how strong this guy is. He knows how much he was humiliated by the first seed. A while back ago, back when he was trying to rise up into the Elite 10s, because he's the 8th seed, he's the 1st seed. If you think about it, he should get wiped out. It's like watching the 8th ranked fighter going against the champion, and then him knocking him back down and showing him, hey, you're not ready yet. Sorry, dude, you're not at my level. That's basically what it feels like. But you have to admire Kuga's admiration, and the fact that he shows vulnerability whenever he's around his opponent, the one that he... because just completely destroyed. He doesn't act like that around Yukihira, even though he knows Yukihira probably in the future down the line is going to be a powerful opponent. But this is the guy who he's got his full attention. And he even tells Yukihira, hey, this is my chance to take him on, all right? And Yukihira, like, he understands, man. He's like, oh, man, I'm a little tired, so I'll let you take this one. Besides, if you get your ass kicked, I'll just be able to avenge you, which kind of feels like that might end up going in this direction, because I don't see how Kuga's going to win. We're at the point of the plot line where the good guys are up 3-0. And if you want to keep it story interested, I've been saying this time and time again, there's no way they're going to wipe them out. That'd be just so stupid. And I don't doubt that they're going to get wiped out. Like, if you look at it match for match, they should probably lose. Megashima's strong as fuck, even though we haven't seen anything from him. But he's going against Rendu, who has a shit ton of hype. She can't lose. There's no way. She has this deviant look, this nice look. She's always been like happy-go-lucky and so nice. But she is the second seed. And on top of that, the first seed, we already know how powerful he is. But we haven't seen the second seed at all. And the only one who I might see winning could be Subaru. But that's because we haven't seen this other Elite 10 guy. We don't know anything about him either. But if you look at it on paper, Subaru should lose. But we haven't seen what his new style is going to bring. What exactly is he going to bring to the table? You know, is he going to still copycat? Which I don't think it is, because ever since he lost to Yukihira, he had said that he was going to reinvent himself when it came to his cooking. So I really think it would like take back his character if he did just stick with the copycat version of his cooking, which to me was kind of dirty, the way he would cheat and go off and like look at information and steal shit, like stalking. That was just so weird. This guy creeped me out, more so in the manga than anything, more in the anime, because of the drawings, his facial expressions were just creepy. But at the same time, I liked his character because it was kind of unique in this cooking story, and it just like, whew, I hope it keeps he keeps the uniqueness though in his cooking. Like, I'm interested to see what he's gonna bring, but I wanted to keep that creepiness, like that nervousness that he brings to the audience that he did back in a while ago when he took out Aldini. So, at the end of this chapter, we get revealed who is gonna be going up against the rebels, and the elite, and it's gonna be the first seat, second seat. And I believe it's the fourth seat. I forget his name, but they're taking on the fourth seat's taking on Tsuburu. Rindo's gonna take on the third seat, Mikishima, and then the first seat is gonna take on Kuga. And I wouldn't be surprised if they get wiped out, the rebels, just so they can keep a balance. But that is kind of predictable. Maybe the rebels can get a win, because it is a little predictable. Because since the rebels wiped them out in the first round, it only makes sense that they would get wiped out in the second round. I was kind of hoping it'd be more back and forth, like one guy wins, this guy wins, two wins here, one wins here. But it's just a wipeout, and then might be more than likely. I'm giving it like a 75% chance this is gonna be a wipeout, but it's gonna be like a strong wipeout. It's gonna be nervousness going back and forth, and I really hope that the judges aren't gonna be unanimous in this next coming matches. I want them to like argue amongst each other. I want there to be split decisions. Split decisions are always the best when the judges have different opinions on what, on whose dish is better. I've always liked those kind of battles. Akita versus Korekiba. That was awesome. That was a split decision, I believe, in the first one, and then it was a draw. That was probably one of the best matches I've seen in Shokugeki no Soma. And it was a split decision. Actually, it was a draw. And the next one ended up being Haima that ended up winning. So I want split decisions in this one. That's how I feel. As far as this chapter goes, it was a solid chapter, a good 4 out of 5. It's basically the hype buildup, and now we just have to see the execution. So yeah, 4 out of 5. Hope you guys liked the review for Shokugeki no Soma Chapter 218. Fan art out. Bye.